Testalone, Rad 140. This is another very popular SARM in the world being utilized by men that are looking for that alternative from using anabolic steroids because of the side effects. Who's using this drug? I don't see the big bodybuilders, the pros. I don't see them using this drug. I see this drug being used as an introductory agent, if you will, from young men that are just putting their foot in the water with PEDs. And they think this SARM, not to mention all the SARMs, are going to be better for them and it's going to be less side effects. We will see. Time will tell. This video will serve as an educational medium for you, the man that's considering using this agent. I'd like you to see my presentation here today, the scientific aspects, and then I want comments. I want testimonies. If you're on Rad 140, please, people, men, please comment here openly. That's the only way we could learn and we could teach each other and other men that are younger men. Are they willing to take the risks? Do they really want to try this drug? And beware. So if you are subscribed to my channel, I thank you so much because look how we're growing. Look where we are today. And if you're not subscribed, I really ask you, please subscribe and share this channel and this medium with any man that is considering using steroids or is on steroids. The history of Rad 140. This is an investigational, non-steroidal, selective androgen receptor modulator. It's derived from oxidiazole aniline group. There's a variety of different types of SARMs, like anabolic steroid science and organic chemistry back in the 60s, 50s to 60s, you have testosterone-derived, you have DHT-derived, you have NOR19-derived. Now you have all these different types of SARMs, and they've been out there for probably about 15 years. This investigational SARM is owned by Radius Health. It's a biotech company, and they're interested in endocrinological disease, osteoporosis, obviously mainly in women, and breast cancer. Now, when I do my research on these, of course, I start off with the scientific aspects. You could look at Wikipedia, Rad 140, and you could read on that. Absolutely incredible. When I'm presenting my videos to you guys, I have to use evidence-based medicine. So let's look at some of the studies. It's interesting that the real first study is in primates, and it was 2011. And it showed an increase in lean muscle mass in primates. And they talk about how this SARM is targeting the androgen receptor in muscles and theoretically leaving out the side effects that you'll see with the carryover and the side effects with real anabolic androgenic steroids. The next very important scientific study that I present to you is in 2017, a preclinical trial with breast cancer, obviously in women. And they found it to be helpful. Now, the interesting piece is that the majority of breast cancer for women is what's called estrogen-positive breast cancers. Those are the receptors that are positive for estrogen on the breast tissue cancer itself. And when you have that status, they classically use aromatase inhibitors like anastrozole and letrozole. Now, those drugs are used in this bodybuilding world, in the PED world, in the anti-aging world, and it's used to limit the aromatization of androgens, of testosterone. You guys know this, and it's incredible. Now, it's amazing that in this study, and it's the real data from the study is not published. I don't know where it is, but it's not published. But I think the study is over, and it was positive, so they're moving on to further human studies. Now imagine the future where women have breast cancer. Usually they're not going to be very young. They're going to be at least middle age, not to mention older. And they probably have some osteoporosis anyway. And then they're taking a drug like an aromatase inhibitor that we know is going to further worsen osteoporosis. Imagine we had a drug that can do two things. It could treat the breast cancer, that's the chemotherapeutic aspect, and at the same side, you're going to limit the side effects and you're going to limit and may even reverse osteoporosis. Treat the breast cancer and actually provide the woman with better bones and with a stronger body. That would be a miracle, and that may be the future. And that's where these drugs are probably headed. Other studies on this drug, legitimate science. Many, many studies with rats show that there is a neuroprotective aspect to this drug. Now, let's look at human beings now, because these are rats. There's no studies, no preclinical trials on this drug with human beings that's being out there, that's being presented. Imagine you're older, you have Alzheimer's dementia, which is terrible. It's an absolutely horrible condition and reality of the world. Imagine that you can give an agent that slows down dementia, treats dementia, and at the same time reverses age-related sarcopenia. So this older person, both men and women, will be stronger and be able to stay at home, and their ADLs, their activity of daily life improve, and they have a better quality of life. Again, more amazing aspects of where we're headed, hopefully, with all these agents. Now, on a side note, Wikipedia presents a study in 2020, just in this year, in January, of how in two cases, you have drug-induced liver disease. Now, I'm not here to scare you. I'm here to tell you that those are two case reports. And everyone knows that real oral anabolic steroids, like even big doses of Anavar, Winstrol, Anadrol, Dianabol, that's going to affect the liver. Certainly dose-dependently and over time, and depending on who you are, what medical conditions you have going on. So, but that's going on here, and it's interesting. In the study, they actually had the drug, and it was real. They actually analyzed the drug, and it was really RAD-140, and the other drug was Ligandrol. So the real drug, my assumption is, in big doses with the wrong person, it led to liver toxicity. The good news is, when you look at the study, over the course of 9 months, 12 months, these two men resolved. We need more studies. We're going to look at studies with these drugs, all SARMs, for cancer cachexia. Also, as I mentioned, dementia and the cancer for women, breast cancer. And just in the future, overall wellness. When you get old, you get sarcopenic, your muscles waste, you get frail. If we could reverse that, that would be beautiful. So we're just in the beginning of this, and that's why it's in the streets. They're not even drugs or agents. They're just out there as substances, and you buy them for your lab rat. This is going to be the comment and the side effect aspect of this video for everyone here. Let's talk about the side effects. And as I go through the side effects, I want you men that are on RAD-140 or have used RAD-140, I want you to comment, be specific. Let's really blow this open. Let's talk from the hair down. Hair loss. Supposedly shouldn't cause hair loss, but we know for some men that it can. Hair loss. CNS, up in the brain. Mood, thought to be better. Energy, my concentration will be better. Malaise and fatigue, does it happen? Libido, now this is on the drug, off the drug. Testosterone suppression, as I've talked to before about other SARMs. Please, let's get it going. Every man's got a fingerprint. Every man is unique. We understand that no two men are going to have the same response. But if we could try to look at some generalizations, that would be great. Gynecomastia, let's move down. Gynecomastia, we know that these are SARMs, that they theoretically will not aromatize. But if you use them with other drugs, and when you come off the SARMs, there is some destabilization of the hypothalamus pituitary gonad axis, testosterone can be suppressed, and estrogen levels can go up, not to mention destabilizing other aspects of your endocrine system. Acne. How about acne? Heart-related, So many men have told me that their heart rates can go way, way up. They can have palpitations on this drug. Blood pressure goes up. Let's talk about that. Have you experienced that? Any dizziness on this drug? Let's talk about labs. Does it affect the CBC like we do with real steroids and even testosterone, where you get polycythemia? The comprehensive metabolic panel, that's going to be the kidney and the liver enzymes. Like these cases I presented in 2020. Have you seen jaundice? Have you checked your labs? Do you see liver enzyme transaminases just bumping up? Kidney, so much about the kidney. It's so relevant and so important. I can't tell you enough. Do you get back pumps? Guys talk about the old classic back pumps. Is that really back pumps because it's affecting your kidney? Is it kidney pain? Like you have hydronephrosis or a kidney stone? This is amazing science and clinical aspects. So have you checked your kidney function on this? Please let it out here. Please comment. Lipids. Everyone knows, even the studies have supported with SARMs, at a certain dose level, you're going to suppress your HDL. That could be dangerous for the heart. Testosterone, total testosterone, free testosterone, sexually binding globulin, estrosensitive estradiol, all these aspects of your testosterone and estrogen. Has anyone measured these on and off? Now, again, these comments, I'd like them to be specific just to men that are using RAD-140 by itself. Because if you're using other drugs, it's not going to be a clear picture. So just with RAD-140, please. PSA. How does it affect your prostate? Many of you young men are so young that you're not going to be concerned for the prostate, but I could tell you as I get older, it's going to come into play. PSA, prostate number, prostatitis, lower urinary tract infections, all these things. How about fertility and semen analysis? Has it affected you or any men, like steroids we know can? Other side effects, injuries. Has there been tendon injuries that we know that men that get super strong on steroids and they can get premature rupture of tendons, bicep tendon, pec tendon, quad tendons, hamstring tendons, Achilles, calf tendons. And the last part is any general comments and recommendations. Please give us some recommendations. Give men, imagine that it's you and you're younger and you use some of these drugs, even steroids, and you want to give your comments, you want to give your opinion to what you would give ethically to a man that's completely new and hasn't ever touched these agents. So if you can give us your heartfelt advice and recommendations for men that are younger, that have not used this agent, that are considering using this agent, open it up. Let's really hear your recommendations. Good recommendations. Recommendations that you would worry that if they use this drug, they'll see XYZ in the future. I hope this really helps. Thank you all so much.